Okay, you're seeing me again because this is a problem that you just missed. Y is equal to 4x minus 16, and y is equal to a negative 4x plus 16. Now, watch me work it and then check your paper to see where you missed it. Again, both of these are already set equal to y, and because they're both already set equal to y, I can replace one of them. It doesn't matter if I move this one down here or if I move this one up here. I'm going to take this one and I'm going to move it right there. So that I'm going to take this whole thing and put it in where my y is. So 4x minus 16 is now equal to negative 4x plus 16. And that's okay, because one's equal to the other. Now, if you took this one and replaced it up here, yours is going to look just like this, only this is going to be over here, and that's going to be over there, and that's okay. All right, so here are my x's. Here's a 4x, here's a negative 4x, and I want those to be together on the same side. Now, most of us like for our x to come over onto the left-hand side, so I'm going to move this negative 4x. To move a negative 4x, I'm going to add 4x to both sides. Take the x with you when you go, okay? 4x plus 4x is 8x, so that's going to be 8x. I'm going to keep my minus 16, and I'm going to set that equal, those cancel out, to a positive 16. So there we go, positive 16. Now, I'm going to solve for my x. So there's my x, which means this minus 16 has to go. So I'm going to add 16 to both sides. Here's my 8x. Those are going to cancel. So 8x is going to equal 16 plus 16, which is 32. And then all I have left to do is divide by 8. So I'm going to divide by 8 on both sides. And when I divide by 8 on both sides, I'm going to get 32 divided by 8, which is x is equal to 4. Okay, because 8 times 4 is 32. And now that I have my x of 4, I can now solve for my y. So when I get ready to solve for my y, I'm going to take my x on my x equals 4, and I'm going to replace it into either of these two equations here at the top. It doesn't matter which one I pick. They're both already solved for y, so I can pick either one. So I'm going to take this, and I'm going to pick the top one because it's a positive number, and I don't have to deal with my negatives. So I'm going to take y is equal to 4 times 4 minus 16. So 4 times 4, so y is equal to 4 times 4, which happens to be 16. And 16 minus 16 is 0. So y is equal to 0. Remember, we write our answer in terms of an ordered pair. So we need our answer to be x, y. Well, my x happens to be 4. My y happens to be 0. So the answer is 4, 0. Which means that if I were to take these two lines and I were to graph them, they would cross at the point 4, 0. So they have one solution, and that one solution is 4, 0. Now you may check your paper, see where you went wrong. You then may move on to the next problem that you need to work. Good luck.